public at large, I believe, the people throughout Earth do not believe that anything can be done about their problems. They've even gotten to a point where these problems are more precious than life. If anything's going to survive, it's got to be the problem. They believe that problems are the finest things to have around because they don't think anything else could adequately occupy their time. It must be this way, otherwise they wouldn't permit a problem of this magnitude to continue to exist in their vicinity. The worst thing in the world that they could do would be to revolt against any existing regime. Revolution never carried anything with it. Never carried anything with it. But chaos and the return with more ardor of the same regime that the populace got rid of. It's the unhappy history of every revolt that ever took place that I know of. They revolt against the King of France and they get Emperor Napoleon. They revolt against the Duke and they get a Duke of Lemonade. They revolt against a civil service system called the government of Russia, and they get a civil service system called communism. So revolution isn't the answer. The answer must lie somewhere in the field of evolution. But evolution cannot take place without better information and more data, and more importantly, this single thing. A hope that something can be done about it. And if we could tell people today, we could demonstrate to individuals today that something actually could be done about it. I don't care what problem we're addressing. You say something could be done about it. If we could tell them this, and that we could do something about it, we would probably just be getting into the entering wedge of two-way communication on the subject of Dianetics and Scientology. I'll tell you the wrong thing to do with Dianetics and Scientology is not to communicate it and not to use it. We know that's wrong. What are the right ways to communicate it? Those we can work out. But any way is better than no way. Every once in a while, a group of auditors may get very dissatisfied with me or the HASI. It has happened. I hear about these things very seldom. They usually fold up before I get a message about them. But they get dissatisfied somewhere or another. They feel that somebody's being too punitive or is upsetting them in some direction or is doing something wrong in some direction. And I'm usually appalled by the fact that they don't know what we're doing. They don't know what I'm doing. They don't know what the organization is doing. They haven't bothered to find out. All they noticed was that somebody was communicating, and their dramatization was to stop it. The only thing that is thoroughly against the law in this universe is to communicate. And the only thing you can do wrong is not to communicate. And between these two factors, you get a very big game. Another thing you can do wrong is to be there. Your parents ever slap you around? Ever say you got muddy shoes, you should comb your hair, why don't you brush your teeth, why don't you mind your manners, why don't you get to school in time? Your parents ever do this to you? Do you know what the crime was? You were there. That's the only crime. And let's suppose that for a moment they didn't notice you were there and you started to communicate. You said, Mama, can I have an apple? Second crime, which is the first and only crime, to communicate. If you cried, don't. If you yelled, don't. Don't communicate. Well, there's one thing that we will never learn. There are a lot of things we have learned organizationally. But whatever the aims, whatever the goals, of Dianetics, Scientology, or the various organizations or people connected with them. There's one thing I know fairly sure, that they will never completely learn. They will never learn to stop communicating. Because auditing with the modern processes we have demonstrates to an auditor time after time that the only thing wrong with his preclear is the fact that he stopped communicating. And if we ever get taught any lesson by preclears, if we ever get taught any lesson by aberration, it will be that to stop communicating and to do nothing is wrong. We'll learn that. If we ever make one human being well, we'll learn that one. Organizational policy would, to a large degree, dictate what we were communicating. And, of course, there are lots of ways we could communicate that are better than other ways. There are lots of ways we could communicate that are worse than other ways. A great many opinions could be expressed on how we should communicate and what we should communicate about. But let's not fall into the trap of punishing every time somebody communicates. If they're communicating about Dianetics or Scientology, let them communicate. You don't have to answer particularly, but let them communicate. Now, this tells you then that there's better ways to communicate than some ways. But even N-theta is better than no communication at all. We'd rather have an erroneous report than none. There are better ways to communicate, but we found out that if we as an organization started to rap the knuckles of every auditor who was trying to communicate sincerely on the subject of Scientology, that we might as well go out back and cut our own heads off with the axe. And we found that out. We're guided by that practice and principle. As far as auditors in the field are concerned, auditors scattered here and there across the world, and I do mean scattered across the world, I can sincerely tell you that I do not know of one of these auditors who isn't trying to do a good job of communication in his own framework and experience. They're all trying one way or the other. Some of them think the only way they can communicate would be to shut off all that darn communication Ron does. There's very little of that, fortunately. Most everybody has learned that it's best to let that one run and run another one too. They can't stop that one anyhow. But these people are trying to do a job. They're trying to keep on communicating. They're trying to be there. And they're trying to resolve some of the problems of man. And our organizational policy today is to do what we can do to help these people in their job of communication and to communicate all we can ourselves. And if anybody finds these organizations hard to understand, it's just because he'd have a hard time understanding communication. Thank you.